mountains. In certain areas has access to the roads, so much, you know, but in for large property.
So apparently it's not that easy. The other guy that I went to originally told me that it was going to be $20,000 for 10 acres. When I went in to talk to him, all of a sudden it's $59,000. It went from $20,000 to $59,000, but it's the developer finances. No credit check, you know, no $500 down. So it sounds like a little shady thing anyway.
So if it was in a flood zone, does that have any reference to you? It means that when it's in an actual flood zone, it means that it could flood every 100 years.
Oh, wow. It's like Vegas. Every time it rains, it's a major catastrophe.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, there are times where it does flood here, but I mean, if you're only using it for an animal sanctuary, it might not, you know, a flood zone might not be a big issue for you. So if this is 20 acres, I mean, you're pretty far out there.
Yeah.
Because this is 20, so this is going to be like 40.
Yeah, as long as I don't hear 20, complaints 20, from...
You're 60 acres away.
Oh, I don't think they can hear them. 60 acres.
I wouldn't think so, yeah.
60 acres away, yeah, that should be enough space.
I would think so.
Oh, there's a neighbor. How close?
Right there. So they're just on the other side of that wash. So they are actually close.
Yeah, that's too close. Yeah, they would definitely, yeah.
You hear the dogs in this stuff. Yeah. It's like a house you can actually get financed for. So if you were to find a piece of land that was out of what you could pay cash for, the only way you could do it financing is if the seller is actually willing to technically be like the bank.
What about credit cards?
If the credit card will give you the cash off of it, then you can do it. Basically, we would be making a cash offer.
Okay, so the banks don't. Okay, good. Yeah, that's good to know. Now I just went to another realtor that said the only thing she had was a place in Golden Valley, which is another little town like Dolan Springs, and that might be in a flood area. And and it's also too close to neighbors. Like the neighbor had, I think, over a wall or something was too close. Can't be next to neighbors when you have an animal sanctuary, because the first thing they're going to do is start complaining about the noise and I'm going to have an issue. So this is a lot more difficult than I thought. And we're going to go eat in that hot diggity dog place that when I spoke to that lady says she has a lot of information. We are in front of Hot Diggity Dog. I had spoken to that lady last week, Diane. Going to go in and see what information I can get from her. And she knows a contractor that might have more information. So let's go check it out.
Oh, yeah. Hey, girl. How are you?
Okay. How are you?
I'm good. I'm supply shopping for the shop right now.
Oh. Are you gonna stop by? We're going to eat something.
Yeah. I'm still about 40 minutes away.
Okay. Should we wait or come back another time?
I would grab something up anyway because it's going so fast. You're not going to go wrong. But the problem is, a lot of people just buy sight unseen and then they're in a wash or they can't get power to the house.
Yeah, they're telling me I just went to a realtor. She didn't have any land.
And I never met people like I met here. They're horrible.
Are they racist?
Not racist.
No? Okay.
Thieves.
I know, because I just saw a realtor who quoted me a price for land, and I went up, and all of a sudden it went up $20,000. The same. I said, "Am I nuts?" Yeah. It was him.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you say there's thieves here?
For instance, I was here Thursday working, went home, they stole my wheelbarrow.
Well, you had it right outside here?
At my house.
At your house? So there's crime here too? You would think, I mean, except for a couple of crack addicts, you would think there's not a lot of crime.
You gotta be kidding me. You don't even know.
Oh, see, I don't. Hi, it's Hope. So we're just out of Dolan Springs. It's freezing. And we went to Golden Valley, same kind of little town. Seems like it's a lot harder finding what I want with electric. People are giving me different stories about piping in. They said the electric company will give you 500 feet line to start with, and you have to bring in the rest. Nobody knows how much it costs. Nobody knows if they will do it. You have to build a structure on the land in order to get piped in electricity. This is what I was told. This is all hearsay, but I think that's correct. So if you get land, you got to build something on it, then they'll give you 500 feet, then you got to pipe in the rest. I don't know how much it costs. So we're in Kingman right now. I just spoke to a realtor in Kingman, and it seems like the property for 10 acres is $149. I think that is with electric. I'm not 100% sure, but regardless, it's too expensive, and then you got to start building everything else on it. So we're just going through Kingman right now. That is the major city that you go to go shopping, from Dolan Springs, Golden Valley, all these little hick towns. And so that's what we're doing right now in Kingman.
I want to do a little synopsis on the day today. So I went in the office today and we're ready to go. And he said, let me look up some land. And he was looking in his book. And then he says, okay. So I found some parcels. He goes, we have 20 acres right here. I said, okay. And that's about how much? He goes, oh, it's $59,000. What happened to the $20,000? You know, I know damn well I wouldn't have gone back if I knew it was that much. And he said, oh, no, it's $59,000. Oh, you pay cash? $39,000. I said, dude, I think we got our wires crossed. And that's why I walked out. I don't want to make a scene. Not necessary. The guy's a ripoff. I walked out of the office. And I'm vigorously looking for this land. But there's a lot of thieves out there from what I'm seeing right now. So I got to be very cautious. I have to look at the flood areas that they call. It's a wash, but don't worry. It's downhill. They're giving me all this bullshit. I need to know from a topographer that studies soil concentration. I will go to that extent, because I'm not going to get ripped off. This is going to be carefully thought out. And when I get it, it's going to be a solid sale. That's going to be something that I can work with.
I found out the water in Dolan Springs to carry on, which that's what you have to do unless you have a water line. It's upheld in tanks. So they deliver the water to you now, but that's how the water is delivered in Dolan Springs, through tanks. Now, if you have a well you can dig, that's a whole other thing. Look, I'm too old at this point to research every fucking aspect of this stuff. So I need some help from you guys, if you know. Okay, now I heard, oh, this is like a semi-flood zone. Well, you'll be at this end of the land. The animals, they're only animals, right? They'll be at the other end of the land. So what? They're saying, like, the flood zone, you could be cool there, but the animals might be flooded out there, but they're only animals. So, you know, that's the kind of shit I'm getting. I'm going there to save animals, not to have them flooded out, you know? So there's several different scenarios about the flood zones that you have to watch out for. You have to watch out that your land is not in one of these flood zones. There's a lot of that shit in the Southwest and Vegas. Arizona, you got to be careful of that shit. So I'm going to have that everything studied securely before I buy this land. I'm going to be very careful. In the meantime, I'm going to be going out there and helping people and doing my thing.
Don't forget to subscribe and share.